You asked for it, and I'm giving it. Katebush experiment 4. Yeah, this was a highly requested Katebush song. I think it kind of got filtered to the bottom of all since all the requests were coming in hot. So I'm here. I'm out of breath. I'm just so excited. ...180 beats per minute or something like that, easily. All right, let's get into it. This was highly requested. Okay, let's go. Oh, real quick. I'm not looking up lyrics. I'm not doing anything like that. I want to watch the video, react to it, raw reactions, what you're getting here. If you feel like you like that, please like, comment, and subscribe. I'm loving the Katebush journey. I'm loving all the journeys I'm currently on with this reaction channel. These you Katebush fans are amazing. I mean, all my fans are amazing. But I'm really loving this Katebush journey. I reacted to Running Up That Hill, and I thought that would be it. And you guys have sent me down a rabbit hole that I don't ever want to get out of. All because of you. I have no idea what to expect. Excellent green screen work. Looks like they're on the like airport treadmills that are like horizontal, and you just George Jetson style. Yeah, that's what I'm getting here. What is it? What's the experiment? She sounds beautiful as usual. Okay. Look how impractical this room is. Giant room for this chair and this little command console looking thing. Is that a double pane two-way mirror or something? Okay, I'll be honest with you. So far, I'm lost. I'm hoping it kind of starts to make sense. She's a little hard to understand in this song. I'll also say that. She's so, like, ethereal sounding. She's like, oh, like, really, like, high-pitched. Well, like, breathy. I wouldn't say how to. She's very breathy with her singing, which she's done before. This is a little hard to understand, so I'm hoping it kind of comes together, or else maybe I have to dive into the lyrics to really, truly react to it. We'll see. Turn it on! It could feel like falling in love. It could feel so What? There she is. Ooh. Oh my god. That was misleading. Okay, all right. Still a little lost, but let's see. Well, that's haunting. Gotta shut it down. We won't be there to be blamed. We won't be there to snitch. I just pray that someone there can hit the switch. But they told us. Okay, I've gotta do it. I need to know what she is saying there. We're pulling up the lyrics. I'm sorry, I said I wasn't going to, but we have to know. Because I don't even know what she's saying with the chorus, and that's not gonna work for me. I just don't wanna be spoiling the meaning until I've figured out my own meaning. But let's go to genius.com. Everyone recommends Genius. All they told us all we wanted was a sound that could kill someone from a distance. So we go ahead, and the meters are over in the red. It's a mistake in the making. Ooh, okay. This is sounding like some sort of crazy military plan. Oh, we might have to watch this again. We'll see. Okay, so this is a military plan. Clearly this dude's also in the military. Giving me like World War II vibes. Okay. Now I hear it. Oh no. Beautifully shot video. Clearly, you know, and we've already know now that she's loved cinematography and the visuals and the storytelling. All of this stuff is really beautifully shot. It's always very, again, ethereal is kind of like my new word for her almost, but like everything has like this kind of foggy, ghostly-like effect. I don't know if that's like a lens effect being, a lens filter or something, or what that is. I mean, again, this was shot in either the 70s or the 80s, so it's kind of hard to say. I mean, clearly there's a lot of practical effects going on. The dude with his eyes like kind of protruding out, but visually really, really cool. This guy. Wait, music for pleasure? Is that what they just, I mean, that looks like that's where they just came out of. Hang on a second. Yeah, music for pleasure. It's looking like Eastern Europe, like an Eastern European country, like those row home, that kind of building that's like a large kind of row home building. Oh, katebush, you're behind it all. Okay, 1986. Okay, so, all right. Clearly, now knowing the lyrics, or the chorus lyrics, that this is clearly some sort of military experimentation gone wrong. They want to be able to kind of maybe take warfare to the distance. Kind of crazy if you think about it, because now we have a lot of drone warfare. A lot of wars are fought from behind a desk, behind a command console. You don't have to actually be on the front lines and still do a lot of damage and a lot of casualties or the cost of that. Yeah, just verse one alone. We were working secretly for the military. Our experiment in sound was nearly ready to begin. We only know in theory what we are doing. Music made for pleasure, music made to thrill. It was music we were making here until... Oh. Oh, okay. So my thoughts on that are maybe this kind of secret military experiment is how can we use music to kill someone from a distance? Can maybe creating like the most like heinous, loud sounding, screeching music that would just completely, you know, end somebody's life potentially. Yeah, from the painful. I don't have to look ahead right now. Then we have the chorus. Then we have from the painful cry of mothers to the terrifying scream. We recorded it and put it into our machine. Yeah, so I'm going to listen to the song over and over and over again until I really can hear it and read the lyrics. But clearly, yeah, there's some sort of an experimentation using music, using sound, using horrible sounds that could be used as a way to... in somebody's life, you know. There's not much here. Then there's the bridge. So yeah, I'll read it because there's only like the bridge in the verse three. It could feel like falling in love. It could feel so bad, but it could feel so good. It could sing you to sleep, but the dream is your enemy. Okay. Y'all are actually seeing what I've been doing with katebush songs after I record and post them. This is literally what I've been doing. I've been going back to the lyrics and just really dissecting them. So I'm doing it live for you. This will be the longest reaction we've ever had, but I'm doing it because this song has had me perplexed. But now that I've read the lyrics a little bit, it's funny how my story is evolving. Each verse and chorus I read, my story is kind of evolving into. And so far, I feel like I'm one step ahead, at least on the music being the source of the weapon. We won't be there to be blamed. We won't be there to snitch. I just pray that someone there could hit the switch. Ooh. Hit the switch to turn the music off or turn it on. I think it means to turn it off because all the damage has already been done. You saw the entire lab just kind of implode and fall apart from this musical weapon that they made. At the end, you see katebush going, you know, the shh, and she walks off. So the enemy, her voice, and this is what I'm thinking, her enemy, like her voice, she got away and everybody else has just expired around her because of what they try to create. And the music itself is everlasting. It goes on. And isn't that kind of poetic? Music is everlasting. even after singers and bands, you know, they pass away, the music still lives. And I think that's really, really, really cool, even though in context for the song, it's kind of tragic, you know, what's going on. I'm actually getting kind of getting chills, like, thinking about this more. Really, really awesome. I'm not sure why I waited so long, but on some hands, I'm kind of glad I did wait a little bit, because I'm starting to understand her a little bit more. My only real critique for the song was it was hard to understand what she was saying without looking at the lyrics first, or without looking at the lyrics. Looking at the lyrics, then it was like, oh, okay, that's obviously what she's saying. But I didn't quite get that the first time around. So that'll be my only critique, and I feel weird even saying that, because katebush is amazing. So thank y'all so much. Thank y'all for the suggestion. Let me know what else I should react to from katebush. I think I have like 4 or 5 more songs on the list, and I got something kind of special in the works as well. If you've been reading the comments a little bit, you might know what's kind of going on or what I'm cooking up. I'm not ready to say exactly yet. I might have alluded to it in some previous videos, but just stay tuned. When I know officially what's going on, I'll let you all know. All right, y'all. Thank you so much. I really appreciate the support. Catch you on the next one. I'm Rowdy, and I'm out.